And it's an assault to democracy, the fragile democracy that Myanmar currently had. We were expecting Aung San Suu Kyi to move mountains and hills to for democracy, but in fact she hasn't. And it was under her watch that more journalists were detained, more student activists were detained, more draconian laws were passed, and we saw a genocide occur in Rakhine. I mean, Minh Oai wanted to be the president so that he can stay in power. The reason he wants to he needs to stay in power is his family has so much at stake in businesses. Businesses run by the military or its cronies or its associates. The people have, I think they won a greater majority, the NLD did. And I think we have to respect and focus on the fact that the people voted for NLD. I'm not sure how much of that vote was towards Aung San Suu Kyi. And we have to, as I say, under her watch, so much atrocities happened. And so I think it's time for the international community to really rethink about how they will approach or address the situation in Myanmar and with whom they will be talking to.